So the AIPGD 2024 exam is over and many students have begun their preparation for AIPGD 2025, or probably many of you will begin your preparation in the coming few weeks or few months. Few students have asked me to share a study plan, a 6-month, 8-month study plan for AIPGD 2025. So in this video, I'm gonna share few important things that is gonna keep you consistent, because if you can start your preparation now and be consistent, stay consistent for the next 8 to 10 months, then there is nothing that is gonna stop you from cracking this exam. By the way, if you want me to share a 6 months or an 8 months study plan for AIPGD 2025, then comment yes in the comment section below. So the first point that I want all of you to keep in mind is that this exam, the preparation for this exam, is a marathon. This is not a short run of 5 kilometers, 10 kilometers that you can cover in few weeks or few months. No, because you see, anything which has a huge impact in your career, which has a huge impact in your life, doesn't happen overnight. It takes time. It requires consistent effort for a longer duration. So even cracking this exam will take months of preparation. So I want all of you to go into that mindset that I have to struggle, I have to study, I have to close all the doors, I have to close all the distractions, I have to study non-stop for the next 8 to 10 months. The next important thing is that students have this habit of cramming everything in one session or in a couple of sessions. And cramming is something which is not gonna help you in preparation of these kind of exams. As for example, students are waking up at 3 a.m. in the morning, studying until 12 p.m., sleeping, and then again studying for 10 to 12 hours. I don't think these kind of marathon sessions, studying in this way, is gonna do any good to your preparation. In fact, what it will do is it will confuse your mind. You will not be able to sustain anything, and that is why you will feel like even after studying so much, you are not able to recollect any information in the exam. And I have noticed that during this preparation, many students are preparing in coaching centers, many students are appearing in tests. So to appear in that test, students are cramming one day before the exam just to make sure that they achieve a good score in that test. But this is not gonna help you. Like I said, this is not a marathon. This is not a one-day show that you appear in one particular test with a very nice score and then you forget everything what you have studied the next day. So instead of cramming overnight for one particular test, remember that you are preparing for a huge exam that is gonna happen in the next 8 to 10 months. So study for 6, 7, 8 hours per day. Most of you must be in your internship right now. Many of you must be having your duties. Few of you might be having your clinics to run simultaneously along with your preparation. So don't think that you have to study 15 hours, 16 hours, because you have this advantage that you are starting early. So study for 6, 7, 8 hours, but be consistent. Every day study for this 6, 7, 8 hours, and you will see that by the end, you will be able to crack this exam. The third important thing is have a plan, have a target, have a goal, and most importantly, have a checklist of what you are gonna study the next day. Similarly, have a goal, have a target, have a checklist of whatever you are gonna study this entire week. And whenever you are able to achieve that, whenever you are able to complete that, check it off. Because this gives you a sense of completion that yes, you have decided, you had a plan that you are going to study 100 MCQs on anatomy and you have completed that in this week. That gives you a sense of achievement that yes, your preparation is on track and you are going in the correct direction. The fourth important point is that whenever you are making this plan, set realistic goals. Don't set a goal which is unrealistic. You know your plan, you know your routine, you know your duty hours, you know your capacity. So accordingly set your plan that you will study 5 medicines of Materia Medica or 10 aphorisms of Organon or 10 pages of anatomy. Don't set a goal which is unrealistic, because I'll tell you right now, you will find a lot of students around you who are hyper motivated. You will see them buying new MCQ books. You will see them buying new textbooks. 3-4 months down the line, these students will be nowhere in the competition. So don't get hyper motivated or have a check of reality. Start with studying only 10 pages daily and thereby improve every day. Next day you study 12 pages. Next day you study 15 pages. And it is not gonna happen that today you have studied 10 pages, tomorrow you are gonna study 50 pages. That is not gonna happen. If you are doing this, then you will burn out. So the important thing is setting a goal, and even more important is setting realistic, achievable goals. The fifth important thing is that whenever you are starting your preparation, start with easier subject, the subject that you find most easy. Don't start with a difficult subject, because then it will take a lot of your time, first of all. Second of all, if you are stuck, you're gonna lose your motivation. So start with the subject. If you find anatomy easy, start with it. If you find FMT easy, start with it. If you find pharmacy easy, start with it. You see, when you complete these smaller and easy subjects, this is gonna give you a sense of achievement that yes, you have completed your preparation. A part of your preparation, a part of your subject has already been done. So when you are starting your preparation, first of all, I would suggest don't look at your friends that your friend has started, say, surgery. So I'll also start surgery. No, maybe your friend finds surgery easy, but surgery is difficult to you. You have not studied surgery very thoroughly in your BHMS exam. And that is why right now you have to give a lot of time to surgery. So better off you start with a subject that you are confident in, the subject which you have studied nicely in your BHMS. Point number six is switching off all your distractions. Now, whenever you are studying seriously, whenever you are sitting down to study, ignore every call, ignore every social media notifications. Because what you're gonna do for the next 8 to 10 months can have a huge impact for the remainder of your life. So vanish from social media for the next 10 months. Vanish from your friend circle for the next 10 months. You are the one who has to decide whether AIPGD 2025 is important, or whether commenting on social media is important, or some post is important. And remember, vanishing for the next 10 months and focusing on only one thing can put you 5 years ahead in life. The seventh and the most important point that you can take away from this video today is revisions. Now, whatever you have studied the entire week, revise on the weekends, because revision is the only thing that is gonna put everything that you have studied for the entire week into your long-term memory. And preparing for these kind of exams, you have to put a lot of data, you have to put a lot of concept, a lot of things into your long-term memory. Because remember that this is not a very easy exam. This exam is very competitive, is very difficult. Because basically you are studying 5.5 years of BHMS syllabus in the next 8 to 10 months. Lastly, I would like to say that there is no single formula that I can give you, that I can share, or there is no formula that you can implement to stay consistent during your preparation. At the end, it is all about developing this attitude. It is all about staying committed to the goal, to whatever you are planning to do in life. Whether AIPGD 2025 is important to you or not important to you. So develop this attitude that you're gonna crack this exam bit by bit. And one thing that I would like to say, that whenever you have planned that you are gonna study, say, 5 chapters every day. Okay, so what I used to do, and I would also recommend everyone of you who is watching this video to do, is that whenever I studied 5 chapters, I used to go that extra bit and complete 5.5 chapters or the 6th chapter. You see, this made me really happy. This gave me a really nice mental boost that yes, I have done something, that I have completed my goals, and I have walked an extra mile. So I would recommend all of you also to try this. This is gonna really make you happy. This is gonna give you that motivation to sit back again and study the next day. Remember, you all are not kids, you all are doctors. You know how important this exam is to you. You know your career, you know your life plan. So you shouldn't expect anyone motivating you every day, because you should find motivation within yourself. Just remember that the student who cracks this exam, or the student who comes first in this exam, is someone who simply sat down every day and studied bit by bit. And ultimately, when the result comes out, we realize that this student has come first. And then everyone gets crazy to ask this topper what was the book that he followed, what was the study plan that he followed, what was the study strategy that he followed, what was the MCQ book that he followed, what was the textbook that he used to follow. And I'll tell you something from my experience, you won't find anything unusual in toppers. The only thing unusual that you will find is that they showed up every day. Hope this video helped you. Share it with your friends, with your colleagues who is also preparing AIPGD 2025 alongside you. Let me know how you like the video. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it. And I'll see you in the next video.